put it on the bank. How shallow should you fish in stained spring water? Throw it up on the darn bank, because that's where the fish are. Keep your eye on the prize, buddy. Put it on the bank. I guess we'll just sit here in this real shallow water. See how many of these bass are out here. Look at you. 15 and a half. Ooh. Hang on. Whoa. There you go. That's a nice fish. Whoa. This might touch 15 and a half also. Calico candy to be just the ticket. There you go. Whew. Another little chunk master. 15, a little over 15. Put it on the bank. I'm right over here in less than 3 feet of water. And we picked the windiest day of the year, which has always been my luck. Bye-bye. Get in there. There you go. It's sitting right on 16, a little over 16. Catch you later. Bye. I bet you this water is not knee deep. Put it on the bank. This big girl was up in about a foot of water. What a beautiful, beautiful girl. And she comes in at 17. Small pods, big fun. Put it on the bank. Hello, little buddy. I think he's caught cold. This water's really, really chilly. Liking that black and blue. See ya. Okay, here we are in Hog Hollow. Ooh, look at there. Something up in there, that's for sure. There's a nice one. Fish. Nice little Zeechie. Very pretty. Very healthy. Very typical of this pond. And this nice fish is 16 and 3/4 inch long. Very pretty. Let's get your picture and get you back in there. I'll see you later. Have a nice spring. Fish up there in about a foot of water. Ooh, come on, Sally, get him up out of there. That's a good one. Hello, I'm just going to get my net. That's what you get for being slow to get your net. Nice fish, though. Put it on the bank. Windy side, foot from the bank. They're all over up in here. That's a pretty good one here. Did you just want to put on a show? Kind of what I figured. 13 and 3 quarters. See ya, buddy. I think this is especially true for springtime, and if the water is staying like this, fish get up in little hidey holes and little pockets and stuff up right next to the bank, and they're just there waiting. They're in basically an ambush position, and anything that swims by or falls out of the sky or whatever, they're all over it. So you don't have to be too far from the bank. Just fish on the bank or right near it. I have to finish this up. This looks like a pretty good way to do it. This fish was right up 6 inches from the bank. For me, the answer to how shallow should you fish in the springtime, throw it up on the darn bank. That's a decent fish. They're pretty real healthy. He's pretty nice, sitting right on. Right, it's on 15. Catch you later. Okay, here's our first guest. Size and species unknown. Ooh, I don't think it's a bluegill though. Gotta get Mr. Case here, Mr. Justin Case. Okay, if we could just take note of something, two things actually. First of all, my tips of my flippers are on the ground, so I bet you this is not 2.5 feet deep. In the springtime, windy, murky, that's what happens. You find the windy side, and a lot of times they're just cruising up and down, going, give me that. Yeah, I'm talking about you. It's a very respectable fish. Really nice. Whoa. Beautiful. And I'm looking at 16 right off the bat. See if you see the same thing. And quite the chunk meister, I might add. Okay, our next contestant. Size and species unknown. Indications are it's a bass because we are going for a ride. All right, buddy, come on. Come on. That happened to me just recently. It's okay. That's what fishing's all about. Rudie, you sure do know how to get in trouble. Winky, thank you for not kicking his butt.